We'll start this video by talking about the transport equation with decay. Now, I know that I promised you that I wasn't going to talk about the transport equation anymore, and so I'm going to add an extra term to the transport equation. So here's the transport equation, ut plus cux, and I add a term au. So this gives me a different equation, and I'd like to investigate what this equation describes. So first, let's get a little bit of intuition for it. And this intuition is essentially the same as the intuition that we have for the transport equation. Remember that we thought of the transport equation as being like a directional derivative. So it was the vector 1c dotted into the gradient of u, and then that was 0. And so that said that that u doesn't change in the direction of this vector. But now we've got this au term, so what I'll do is I'll put it on the other side, and I'll say that this is minus au. So here we have a directional derivative, and that's equal to a multiple of u. If this were just an ordinary derivative, like du dt is equal to minus au, that would describe exponential growth or decay, depending on the sign of a. I'll assume here that a is positive, so it would be exponential decay. So this is a directional derivative, which is not that much different than an ordinary derivative. And so what this is describing is exponential decay in the direction of 1c. So it's a directional derivative proportional to u. All right, and the main reason that I introduced this example is because it's a very good example to illustrate the method of characteristics. So let's solve this equation using the method of characteristics. Okay, so you remember the general formula that describes the way that u changes along a characteristic line. That's du dt is ux dx dt plus ut. Now, let's try to make this guy look like our transport with decay. And so in order to do that, we would do kind of like we did with the transport equation. Dx dt is c, right? But now, before du dt was 0, but now I've got this extra au term, so I'll make du dt equal to minus au, and that will be my characteristic equation. So this is the transport equation with decay, and we compare it directly just like this. And so what we get is the characteristic equations, du dt, actually let me write the x one first. Dx dt equals c, and du dt is equal to minus au. Now let's sketch a little picture here, just so we can think about the way that characteristics are working. And so I have x and I have t, and the characteristic lines are, or characteristic curves in general, are given by dx dt equals c. And remember, that implies that we have a solution x minus ct equals x naught. And so that there are these lines of slope 1 over c that we've been seeing over and over again. So these are these lines, x minus ct equals x naught, and they intersect here at x naught. So that's the information that we get out of this equation. Now, this equation tells us how to propagate the value of u along this curve. So we better start out with an initial value that we know. So let's add that to the problem here. Let's add u of x comma 0 equals f of x. So this is just a totally generic initial condition. So what this equation then will tell us is how to propagate the value of that we're given, this f of x value, it would be f of x naught, along this line here. Okay, well, what would I do if I just sort of solved this equation naively? Well, du dt is minus au. That would be u as a function of t. So in other words, u of x of t comma t, where this is the characteristic line, that's equal to some constant times e to the minus at. So this is the information that we get out of our characteristics here. Now let's use our initial value. Okay, so the initial value says what? The initial value says that plugging in 0 for t gives us u of x 0 comma 0, and that's equal to, we know that's equal to f of x 0 for 1, but we also know that's equal to k times e to the minus a times 0, because we know how this equation, the solution to this equation along the characteristic line. So this is equal to k. So in general, we then have that u of xt equals f of x naught times e to the minus at. And this is, remember, this is along, so this is along x minus ct equals x naught. And just like before, we can drop the reference to x naught. X naught is just an arbitrary guy which describes which characteristic line we're on. We can drop that reference simply by using x minus ct instead of x naught, because if I choose any point in the plane, x comma t, then x minus ct will be exactly the point at which that the line, the characteristic line, going through that point intersects the axis. So I have that this expression can be written in terms of just x and t alone as f of x minus ct e to the minus at. And so that is our final solution. Okay, so we drop the reference to the original characteristic line. And so we have a general solution, u of xt equals f of x minus ct times e to the minus at. So let me summarize very quickly, and that is that we found via the method of characteristics that the rate of change of u along a characteristic line was given by minus au, while the characteristic lines were given by dx dt is equal to c. And so using that information plus an initial condition, we found a general solution. It always helps me to plug in some numbers to get a better understanding of what's going on. So I took the equation from the last slide, the transport equation with decay, and plug in some numbers. So we take c equals 3, a equals 1 here, and the initial condition f of x, that's e to the minus x squared. All right, so by the, and actually I should note that this is called an initial value problem. Of course, we've talked about this. So by the calculations from the last slide, we get a solution, and that solution is e to the minus, and I plug in x minus 3t for x here, that quantity squared, times e to the minus t. And so just note parenthetically here, this is our f of x minus ct, and this is our e to the minus at. All right, I've got a surprise for you. I made a movie in Mathematica, so let me go get it. All right, I'm back with the movie. So what you see here is the initial wave profile, and that's the function e to the minus x squared. That's our initial condition, e to the minus x squared. This is a bell curve or this Gaussian curve here. Now I'm going to play the movie, and what you're going to see is that initial profile evolve according to the transport equation with decay. Okay, so what you're seeing here is the wave moving forward with a speed of 3, in this case, c equals 3, and decaying at the same time at an exponential rate according to the multiple of e to the minus t. Now just to illustrate, let me get rid of that decay term, this e to the minus t, so we just see a traveling wave. So I've gotten rid of the exponential decay term, and now what you'll see is the initial profile evolving just according to the ordinary transport equation. So there it is, moving forward with a speed of c. I'd like to finish this video by talking about one more variation on the transport equation, and this is nonlinear transport. So the only difference here is that I have a coefficient x, so it's not c, it's not a constant speed of transport, but now it's x, it's a variable speed of transport. Let me point out one technical thing, an issue of language here. I say nonlinear transport, but I don't mean to imply that this is a nonlinear differential equation, because in fact it is not. It's a linear differential equation. I use nonlinear to describe the transport. We'll see that the transport takes place along curves which are not lines. They are in fact exponential curves. So let's get right to that. using the method of characteristics, I would find that dx dt is equal to x, and du dt is equal to 0. So in other words, the characteristic curves are described by this differential equation, and the evolution of u along the characteristic curves is described by this differential equation. Now this first one can be solved very easily. I would get x equals x naught times e to the t. X naught, again, is this arbitrary constant describing the solution of this differential equation. Now, let's draw a little picture just to sort of see what kind of a picture I have in terms of these characteristic curves. And these characteristic curves, they're exponential curves. So what I would have is I would start at some point x naught, and I would have exponential growth. And of course, it would continue back this way. And as I get closer, so let me point out that this intersection right here, that's x naught, because that's when time t is equal to 0. So x is equal to x naught at that point. And if x naught gets smaller, as I get smaller, then I get a coefficient which is smaller in front of the exponential function, so it'll be spread out a little more. And in fact, when it's negative, I get something pointing in the other direction. Hopefully you see that this should be a mirror image. And in fact, when it's zero, I just get the t-axis. Okay. So these are the characteristic curves. They're exponential curves described by this coefficient, a whole family of them described by this coefficient in front. Now, what happens with u? Well, du dt is 0, and so that means that u doesn't change along the characteristic curves. So that says that u of x comma t is equal to, well, it starts off at f of x naught, if I'm on a particular characteristic curve, and this is along the characteristic curve x equals x naught e to the t. And so, as usual, I can get rid of the x naught, the reference to which characteristic curve, simply by using x naught equals x over e to the t. And so that means that u of x comma t is equal to f of x naught is equal to x over e to the t. And I emphasize that what this means is I can pick any point in the plane, x comma t, and I know that if I evaluate x over e to the t, that'll give me that point x naught where this thing hits there. So that'll give me the value that I need to push along the characteristic curve by this equation. Okay, so I made a movie. What I did was I took the initial value of f of x equals e to the minus x squared. So it's that same Gaussian curve profile that we saw in the last video. And now you can watch it evolve according to this nonlinear transport. So what you're seeing is the values of the wave moving along each of these exponential lines. So for instance, if I start off at along this line, the 0, x equals 0, I stay the same. If I move a little bit to the right, then I watch that value propagate forward in time on this exponential curve.